Hi, I'm Skip Talbot. Thank you for checking out my video. What you're watching here is about 30 hours of footage documenting tornadoes and severe weather across the Midwest and Great Plains. I've compressed this footage into a 2-hour time-lapse production. Most of the footage has been sped up about 16 times. I've been chasing storms since 2003. I always found it very difficult to get good video while chasing. I'm constantly repositioning and driving, which makes it hard to get a steady shot from a moving vehicle. I have to stop and get the tripod out to do any sort of real video work. Many times I'll be driving along and something will happen right in front of me and I won't be recording and I'll miss the event. Other times a tornado will drop behind me and I won't be able to record it either. In 2008 I started building a project that would enable me to shoot stable video while driving at the same time. On the top of my van I put an acrylic dome which houses my video camera. The video camera is mounted on top of pan and tilt servo motors. This setup enables me to get a steady shot from any angle with an unobstructed view. The video you're watching here is from May 15th, 2009 in Central Illinois. This was my first really successful test of the camera dome. I had taken it out a couple of days earlier on May 13th, which had a big tornado outbreak in northern Missouri. I actually intercepted a tornado that day and we were able to stream it live over the internet using the camera dome. However, the video from that day was lost due to a glitch in the camera. This was the first day we were able to actually salvage the video from our chase. This storm had actually formed on the Mississippi River near Missouri. It had been tracking across Illinois for about 4 hours and it was tornado worn the entire time. This is about when the storm looked like it was at its strongest. You can see the updraft base here ingesting some air. It's probably a wall cloud right there. That was about where the storm peaked. The storm never dropped a tornado, but as you can see here, it exhibited a lot of dramatic shelf cloud structure. The storm was probably north of a boundary that kept it from ingesting the warm, moist air that it needed. You can see that there's a lot of reflection inside the dome. The dome isn't yet complete, so there's a lot of wires and other things reflecting inside of it. Wind shear on this day was excessively strong. This storm was probably moving around 60 miles an hour. Normally this is not a feasible speed to chase storms at. Usually you can't keep up with a storm moving that fast. The road grid in Central Illinois is absolutely amazing though. It's mostly paved and not very populated. I was able to maintain high speeds and stay ahead of the storm for the duration. I actually chased this storm from just east of the Mississippi River to Champaign County, Illinois. I was probably on it for about 5 hours. Storm was also very high precipitation. I had to stay right in the inflow notch here in order to maintain a view of the inflow. The camera dome was especially handy on this day. I didn't have much time to stop and shoot video. The storm was moving so fast I had to constantly be moving to stay ahead of it. Getting out from underneath the storm again here, you can see what looks like some sort of downdraft sloping right through the storm there. It's cutting a big swath. That's probably undercutting the storm and limiting any sort of tornado potential that it has. Almost looks like there's two shelf clouds here. Just very weak, broad rotation on this storm. You can kind of see that left to right motion there as it passes. As the storm wears on, you can see it's starting to lose its structure. There's a lot more scud being ingested in the storm. It looks like it's becoming outflow dominant. At this point, I was pretty much just chasing to get structure shots of the shelf cloud. I had a local spotter pull up to me and we were chatting at this time. I was able to basically inform him that chances for a tornado at this point were probably pretty low, even though the storm was still tornado warned. You can really see the storm starting to fall apart here. It looks like multiple gust fronts are fanning out in front of it. As the condition of the storm weakened, I finally decided to give it up near Champaign County, as I decided it was never going to produce a tornado. I got one last good shot of the shelf cloud here, just as a train happened to be passing underneath it. Then I decided to punch it north and head for home. The storm was severe warned at the time for high winds and heavy hail, but I decided that it was probably okay to core punch this storm. Driving north into the storm here, I probably hit some hail that was mostly pea size, maybe approaching penny size. Nothing too severe. Winds got pretty gusty here, maybe 50 to 60 miles an hour, but nothing too bad.